Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. And welcome to another ugly news, kind of bite-sized cosmetic industry stories that don't quite make a full When Beauty Turns Ugly video. But you know, I thought it was still kind of interesting. First things first, people have been asking me about my skin recently, looking dewy and clear. It's not my real skin. It's either been a sunscreen or a cushion compact. I'm trying a few different ones to kind of see what ones are nice and kind of like natural-ish looking. Let's start off with a kind of weird one. An eye drop company has been called out by the Advertising Standards Association for its fake advertising, basically. The ASA have filed a complaint against an eye drop brand called Fancy Eyes after a Facebook advert that the brand had paid for kind of went viral, kind of drew their attention to it. And this advert claims that with these eye drops, you can change your eye color. I mean, that's not possible. That was possible, it'd be like a huge like medical miracle, scientific discovery, and we'd all know about it. They are a US-based company and their advert said, sold out 5 times for a good reason. You will throw away your colored contacts. Introducing the revolutionary color-changing product. Fancy drops reduce even the dark brown eye color for those who want a light eye color. So with these drops, I can change my brown eyes to a blue. According to them, allegedly. The complaint obviously challenged whether the claims of changing your eye color was actually true and kind of raised a lot of questions about the safety of these actual products. They say that basically it's impossible to change your eye color using drops. Therefore, the advertising was misleading and they concluded that the claim has not been substantiated and was misleading. Fancy Drops basically completely ignored the ASA, which I think can lead to legal issues for them further down the line. And because they couldn't provide any evidence that their products actually work, they didn't even use their own before and afters, which we'll get into in a minute. So they had to take down the advert and they are not allowed to advertise with that kind of language or kind of a suggestion of what their product does ever again. Now, I took a look at their reviews and some of the before and afters on their website, and at first, I was like, oh my God, does this actually work? Because there are a ton of reviews. Usually when a website do fake reviews, there's maybe like 3 like reviews at the bottom. And it's like stock footage, stock images of like some random people. But I was looking at their reviews and there was just so many 5-star reviews. But when I really took a really deep look at them, they are all so clearly photoshopped and very, very poorly photoshopped too. When you take a really good look, you can see that the irises are the wrong shape. For some reason, they're not fully round. They're all morphed into different shapes. Some of the colors have just been painted onto the irises as well. And there's this one in particular where apparently the lady's gone from brown eyes to blue. But then you can actually see that in the before, her brown eyes, they've actually just darkened the eyes. They're pretty much black. They're so badly done. I can't believe like anybody has fallen for that. But yes, keep an eye out for Fancy Drops and tag me if you see any of their suspicious advertising. ASOS have been called out for copying Maybelline's viral TikTok video to celebrate the launch of Kylie cosmetics available at ASOS.com. I've had a lot of people call it ASOS. It's ASOS. I used to work there. I know how to pronounce it. So yes, they have been accused of copying Maybelline when one of their adverts went viral for pretty much all the wrong reasons. Do you remember this video here, of the Maybelline London tube train going through the tube station? It's got these cute little eyelashes on the top and then the mascara wand kind of like goes through the eyelashes. Really, really cute, not real, it was CGI, but it went viral because it was just so clever and so well done and it almost looked real. Like I was even like, how does that tube train go through the actual tunnels if it's got eyelashes, you know? Well, the original thinkers over at ASOS social team thought, why don't we do our own version of this, and created a somewhat questionable version to celebrate the launch of Kylie Cosmetics. And this shows a Kylash mascara going through a tube station. It's weird, like it doesn't look like a train or the product. It just kind of looks like some weird styrofoam thing going through a tunnel, I don't know. Now it's obvious ASOS were gonna get called out for copying the Maybelline video because the Maybelline video went truly, truly viral. The London tube station version has over 279,000 views on TikTok. The New York subway station has over 12 million views on TikTok. So ASOS were going to get caught copying, basically. And as I mentioned, not only is it copying, but the CGI just isn't up to par with the Maybelline one. It looks very cheap, a little bit like free to download Backrooms game kind of CGI. I mean, ASOS social media isn't really known for their original content. I feel like they're not really known for their content in general. As I mentioned, when I used to work there, I know that a lot of the content tended to be their version of other people's content. And the team at the time didn't necessarily help create original content. Like, their ASOS, their YouTube should be bigger than mine. But yeah, their content has always felt a little bit copycat. Let me know if you think this was like an inspired copy, or if you think Maybelline's version wasn't even original. There must be some interesting guerrilla marketing around tube stations, right? But Kylie is now available at ASOS for anyone who cares. 1 million mums boycott Aveno. Now, before you get excited, it's not really 1 million mums. In my opinion, it's maybe like 20 mums and the rest are like men disguised as mums. So for those who don't know who the organization 1 million mums is, they are a very conservative group based in America whose mission, I'm doing this so much, whose mission it is to protect children against immorality, violence, and vulgarity and profanity, in their own words, that they feel is pushed onto children from the media, being classic traditional media to social media. However, they have been designated as a hate group. Some of their more notable campaigns include boycotting American Girl dolls because one American Girl doll had some lesbian aunties, and also they boycotted Toy Story because there were also lesbian parents in that. They don't really like lesbians. And in this particular case, expressing concern over a child in an Aveno ad wearing an astronaut suit and a ballerina tutu. This advert is very simple, very classic children's advert of some kid having a bath and there's a toy raccoon. And it's like, I don't know, fucking Bubbles. I don't know what they said. But then at the end, the kid is dressed up in an astronaut costume with a tutu on, a rainbow tutu. So of course everyone was triggered. The raccoon says, "A ballerina astronaut, awesome." 1 million mums couldn't fucking stand this. They went crazy. So on their website, which reads like the diary of a conservative Christian from the 1800s, it's hilarious, you should go check it out. They say, by featuring a supposedly non-binary child, Aveno Kids has, can I just stop there first of all? Just because a kid is wearing an astronaut, a child is wearing an astronaut costume and a tutu, it doesn't mean they're non-binary. They're just fucking playing dress up. Like, calm down a second. Aveno Kids has introduced a controversial marketing campaign they should have avoided. In fact, the focus of the commercial is gender dysphoria and not the product itself. Unfortunately, the initial victim of this disgusting commercial, sorry, it's not funny. It's just, it's almost satire, like it's so ridiculous. The initial victim of this disgusting commercial is the young boy cast in this ad, not to mention any child who views the commercial. The sexualization and the sexualization and the moral corruption of these children, and that's not fun. Obviously, I'm not laughing at that. Hang on. Obvious children are examples of child exploitation at its worst. No child should be introduced to the experience of mental disorders through a commercial. It's not funny. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to lie. Obviously, everything they mentioned in that isn't funny. Child exploitation isn't funny. But the way they write about something is so innocent. Then link all this craziness, crazy claims to it. Or a very simple advert is almost satire. Like, it's almost so weird, it's funny. They're weird making it sexual. There is nothing sexual about this advert. American children in beauty pageants is another story they might want to focus on. And priests, they might want to focus on that too. It seems like Aveno have kept their mouth shut about this. It seems like they haven't really been bothered by this 1 million mums, you know, 100 angry men in a room, I believe it is, rather than mums. It seems like they kept their mouth shut, which I think, well done to them. They don't really need to comment on this whatsoever. In my opinion, trying to attach a message to this advert and to this boy, which is anything other than him having fun and dressing up, is weird. It's so strange. It's very strange. It's worrying. Let kids dress up. Let them have fun. Listen, as a gay man, playing with Barbies and Bratz dolls isn't what made me gay. I didn't hold a Bratz doll or put on a skirt and I was like, oh my God, this is it. This is it. It also didn't make me non-binary. It also didn't make me trans, didn't mean because I'm wearing a a skirt. It's so, it just shows a lack of understanding about any of that kind of subject matter. It's so bizarre. As I mentioned, they are classified as a hate group. I highly recommend, actually, maybe don't, maybe I don't want to give them traffic, but their website is like the funniest thing because it's absolutely ridiculous. Ridiculous. As I mentioned, it was almost like The Onion. It's almost satire. It's strange, very strange. So everyone's poor, but we're all spending money on cosmetics according to the lipstick index. The lipstick index comes from the idea that people like to buy small luxuries. That mainly being, for example, one of the biggest small luxuries purchased is a lipstick. So the lipstick index kind of tracks all these kind of like what people are spending money on, what luxury people are spending money on. And that doesn't mean designer goods, all that kind of stuff. I explain that terribly, but you'll get it in this. So yeah, all this stems from the idea that when we have less money, we like to treat ourselves and spoil ourselves with these mini luxuries that, you know, make us feel good. Mascaras, face masks, lipsticks, things that make us feel fancy. Now, as you are probably aware, here in the UK, we are in a cost of living crisis. That means that cosmetic sales have skyrocketed in the last year. With the UK spending £6.4 billion on cosmetics this year alone, that's roughly $8.4 billion. With London spending the most at over 900 million, makes sense, a lot more people, a lot more shops. And these small luxuries include lipstick and mascara, as I mentioned, but also lip gloss and lip liner, while clothes sales are actually plummeting, which is strange because they were on the rise during lockdown when no one went outside to see them. I know I had to buy more because I put on weight, so I had to buy a whole new wardrobe. Then coming in after cosmetics was things like wine, beer, and chocolate as well. I thought that was interesting. I just find it so weird. It makes sense when, like, you don't have a lot of money. Like when I lived in London, I was constantly just living to survive. Did like work and survive, I would buy myself small, what I considered small luxuries. And that would be like, I wouldn't take in my own lunch. I'd go to like Boots and get a meal deal. And that would be my small luxury for the week. Or I'd buy a nice sheet mask or, you know, all those kind of little things that make you feel like you're doing something bougie whilst you kind of like are struggling with money. Cosmetic retailers are actually really struggling as well at the moment. Luxury retailer Farfetch have decided to close their cosmetics division. Well, their beauty division. And it's only really been a couple months over a year since their initial launch back in 2022. They did launch, as you'd expect a luxury retailer to, with some really, really expensive brands. They launched with Augustina Bada, Dr. Barbara Sturm, Charlotte Tilbury, Ren Skincare, Sunday Riley, 111 Skin, Aesop, and Gucci, to name a few. Very typical brands you look at and you're like, oh, if that was 10 to 20 pounds cheaper, I might buy it. You know, all those kind of luxury brands that come in glass packaging. And this comes after reportedly that they struggled with consumer demand and inventory management, mainly over in the US. Now, they are actually yet to confirm 100% that they are closing down. They might have done as of when this video is posted. But according to industry.beauty, they suggest that the news has been supported by posts on LinkedIn because various staff members have been posting about their redundancy and looking for new work. From what I remember, Farfetch Beauty actually launched because they acquired a beauty website called Violet Grey. Now, Violet Grey is, of course, tangled up in all this, but Violet Grey is still going to be run by Farfetch as its own thing, as its own company. On the news of shutting down, Amyris, I believe it's pronounced, filed for bankruptcy. And they're looking to sell all their consumer brands and focus on ingredients. Now, Amyris are a synthetic biotech company. So what they really, really focus on is creating lab-made sustainable ingredients. On their website, they say, using sugarcane fermentation, we convert basic plant sugars into rare, bio-identical molecules, essential ingredients, and clean, effective, everyday products. Gling. When I first heard this, I was like, oh, that's sad, but I don't think I know any like Amyris brands. Well, I do, and you probably do. Probably their biggest is Biossance, which I used to love. I don't use it as much because their clean messaging kind of started to get on my nerves. JVN, hair care products, Rose Ink, Stripes by Naomi Watts, and For You by Tia. So as I mentioned, sugarcane, all that kind of stuff, very much Biossance, right? I feel like they were their claim to fame. And whilst it is disheartening to see the words science and clean with on the same web page, they do some really important work and some really interesting stuff, you know, for the beauty industry, which does have such a huge environmental impact. So it's cool to see what they're doing. Part of me thinks, is this like clean beauty going out? Because all their brands were clean beauty. And I wonder if that has anything to do with it, that people just weren't buying these clean beauty brands. You can only hope. So, of course, as well as laying off loads of employees, they are actually selling their cosmetic brands, including Biossance and JVN and Rose Inc., hoping to save over $250 million. You know, it really is sad to see a lot of the beauty industry struggling so much. Like, I know a lot of influencers who have brands have spoke out about this. A lot of, like, brands are failing. A lot of new brands just aren't getting the attention they deserve. Or, you know, it seems to be struggling a lot. And it's weird because we just talked about how people are buying more beauty, but they're not buying these products that really aren't necessary, you know? As we mentioned, these little luxuries are little things that make a difference and that they can use all the time. Your classics, lipstick, mascara, etc. So yeah, it makes sense that people may be struggling themselves and they're not wanting to spend money on, you know, things that really aren't all that necessary. Let's be honest. There we go. I hope you enjoyed this month's ugly news. I don't do it every month. I don't know. Whenever I do it, whenever I see stuff I like. You can watch the whole When Beauty Turns Ugly playlist here. Some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.